وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى Today I'm going to start a series and this series will be based on a hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. This hadith is very profound and there are many benefits that we can take from it. And I'm going to take, inshallah ta'ala, waqafat. Not just one, but many benefits from it, inshallah ta'ala. The hadith is a hadith al-Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, narrated in his sahih. On the authority of who? Our mother Aisha, radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, قالت دخلت امرأة, a woman entered, معها ابنتاني, she had two daughters, لها تسأل. She had two daughters and she was asking on behalf of these two daughters of hers. فَلَمْ تَجِدْ عِنْدِي شَيْئًا غَيْرَ تَمْرَةٍ فَأَعْطَيْتُهَا إِيَّاهَا. Aisha said, I had nothing to offer her. After she asked me, I had nothing to give her other than a date. Okay? And this date, Aisha said, when I gave it to her, فَقَسَمَتْهَا بَيْنَ ابْنَتَيْهَا. She took the date and she split it into two. وَلَمْ تَأْكُلْ مِنْهَا, and she did not eat anything from that date. ثُمَّ قَامَتْ فَخَرَجَتْ, then she stood up and she left. Aisha saw that. Aisha then said, فَدَخَلَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَيْنَا فَأَخْبَرْتُهُ. The Prophet entered and I told him what I saw. I saw a woman who had two daughters. She came in and she asked on behalf of these two daughters for something. Okay? And Aisha said, I had nothing to give to her, O Messenger of Allah, other than one date. I gave her that date and she split that date into two and she gave one to her first daughter and the other one to her second daughter and she never ate anything. The Prophet, when he was told the story, he said, من ابتلي من هذه البنات, anyone who is tested with daughters. من ابتلي من هذه البنات بشيء كن له سترا من النار. Anyone who Allah gives them daughters and he takes care of them, that will be a cause for Allah to protect him from the hellfire. Another wording said, من يلي من هذه البنات شيئا, anyone who stands up for the affairs of daughters, girls, فأحسن إليهن, and he takes good care of them, كن له سترا من النار, these girls will be the means for the hellfire to be protected from you. This is restricted to only daughters, not sons. And does that daughter have to be your daughter? Not necessarily. It's just as long as you raise a girl. فَأَحْسَنَ إِلَيْهِنَّ, and you're good towards them, in the sense where you teach them what is beneficial for them, you nurture them to be strong and able to take on the world in a positive, good way. كُنَّ لَهُ سِتْرًا مِنَ النَّارِ. You bring them closer to Allah and teach them about their deen, that will be a veil for you the day of judgment. Imam Muslim narrated that Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, and this is the Muslim's wording now, جاءتني امرأة, a woman came to me, ومعها ابنتان لها, she had two daughters. فسألتني, she asked me, فلم تجد عندي شيئا غير تمرة واحدة فأعطيتها إياها. She asked me for what? Something to eat. And Aisha said, I had nothing to give to her except one date. So I gave it to her. فأخذتها, she took that date from me. ف فَقَسَمَتْهَا She divided, split that date into two. بَيْنَ بْنَتَيْهَا Between her two daughters. وَلَمْ تَأْكُلْ مِنْهَا شَيْئًا And she didn't eat anything from it. ثُمَّ قَامَتْ فَخَرَجَتْ He stood up and she left. وَبْنَتَهَا And her daughters also went up and stood up with their mother and they went. فَدَخَلَ عَلَيَّ النَّبِيُّ Aisha said, the Prophet entered onto me. فَحَدَّثْتُهُ I told him حَدِيثَهَا The story of this woman. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ The Prophet said, مَنِ بُتُلِيَ مِنَ الْبَنَاتِ بِشَيْءٍ فَأَحْسَنَ إِلَيْهِنَّ كُنَّ لَهُ سِتْرًا مِنَ النَّارِ That's what Muslim narrated. Another wording says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَوْجَبَ لَهَا بِهَا الْجَنَّةِ أَوْ أَعْتَقَهَا بِهَا مِنَ النَّارِ That woman you saw, she's going to be from the people of Jannah because of what she did. Jannah has become wajib for her. Or, Aisha said, maybe he said, or even the narrators, one of them might have said, or what she just did for her daughters is a reason for her to be freed from the hellfire. And Imam al-Bukhari narrated this in his Adab al-Mufrad as well. Tirmidhi narrated in his Jami' Ibn Majah in his Sunan, and also Ibn Hibban in his Sahih, and Ahmad in his Musnad, and Al-Imam Abu Abdullah al-Hakim al-Naysaburi narrated in his Mustadrak. I'm now going to go over some benefits that we can take from this hadith. The first thing that we can take from it is جَوَازُ الْمَسْأَلَةِ عِنْدَ الْحَاجَةِ وَالضَّرُورَةِ The permissibility of asking for something when there is a need for it. When there is a what? When there is a need for it. If a person doesn't need anything, just to ask for it, just for the sake of asking for it, is not allowed in Islam. As we can see in the hadith, Aisha mentioned, فَسَأَلَتْنِي She asked me. To just ask and beg people when there is no need for it in Islam, that is not allowed. And there has come many evidences from the Prophet ﷺ where he warned against this. Al-Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated in Hadith Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma mentioned, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما يزال الرجل يسأل الناس A person, if he carries on asking the people, what will happen to him? ما يزال الرجل يسأل الناس حتى يأتي يوم القيامة ليس في وجهه مزعة لحم. The person will come and there will be no skin on their face the day of judgment. This shows what? The prohibition of asking when there is no need for it. Muslim also narrated in his Sahih min hadith Abi Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man sa'ala an-nasa amwalahum. The person who asked the people's wealth. And the reason why he asked the people for their wealth and the purpose why he's asking is takathuran. He has the wealth. He's not in need of it. He's just asking so he can have more. فَإِنَّمَا يَسْأَلُ جَمْرًا That person is asking for what? He's asking for a hot charcoal, a hot fire, burning rock. فَلْيَسْتَقِلَّ أَوْ لِيَسْتَكْثِرُ It's upon you how much rocks of the hellfire you ask for or how little you ask for. Also Bukhari and Muslim both narrated in Hadith Abi Huraira that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ لَأَنْ يَأْخُذَ أَحَدُكُمْ Habla, the Prophet said, I swear by the Lord, my soul is in his hand. لا يأخذ أحدكم, one of you does not take حبله فيحتطب على ظهري خير له من أن يأتي رجلا فيسأله أعطاه أو منعه. The Prophet said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, I swear by the Lord in which my soul is in his hand. لا يأخذ أحدكم حبله For one of you take a rope, فَيَحْتَطِبَ عَلَىٰ ظَهْرِهِ خَيْرٌ لَهُ And then to place that rope on his back, يعني becomes a self-employed or a person who looks for a job. Even if it means that the job that you take is very basic, but it's better for a person to go out there and get a job. It's better for you. خَيْرٌ لَهُ مِنْ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ رَجُلًا Than to come to a person, فَيَسْأَلَهُ And he asks him, أَعْطَاهُ أَوْ مَنَعَهُ Whether the person gives it to you or not, doesn't matter. Also, Bukhari and Muslim both narrated On the authority of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, anna nasa min al-ansari sa'alu Rasulallah. A group of people of Ansar, they came to the Prophet and they asked the Prophet, fa'a'tahum. They asked the Prophet for something, the Prophet gave it to them. Thumma sa'aluhu, they asked the Prophet again. Fa'a'tahum, the Prophet gave it to them again. Thumma sa'aluhu, they asked him again. Fa'a'tahum, the Prophet gave it to them. Hatta nafada ma indahu, until what he had the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all of it went. فَقَالَ لَهُمْ حِينَ أَنْفَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ بِيَدِهِ. When the Prophet gave everything which he had, and the Prophet was very generous, عليه الصلاة والسلام. When he gave everything he had, he said to them, مَا يَكُونُ عِنْدِي مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلَنْ أَدَّخِرَهُ عَنْكُمْ. Wallahi, any good I knew that I have, if I had the wealth in my possession right now, فَلَنْ أَدَّخِرَهُ عَنْكُمْ, I will never store it from you guys. وَمَنْ يَسْتَعْفِفْ يُعَفِّهِ اللَّهِ. وَمَنْ يَسْتَعْفِفْ, anyone who shows chastity, يُعَفَّهُ اللَّهُ, Allah will what? Allah will take care of you and make you chaste and make you rich from the people. وَمَنْ يَسْتَغْنِي يُغْنِهِ اللَّهُ. If you become self-sufficient from the people, Allah will make you self-sufficient from the people. وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ, and anyone who shows patience, يُصَبِّرْهُ اللَّهُ, Allah will place patience in you. وَمَا أُعْطِيَ أَحَدٌ عَطَاءً خَيْرًا وَأَوْسَعَ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ. And there is no gift, يعني, there's nothing given to a person better than يعني, patience. Better than all the wealth on the face of this earth, the Prophet said. Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله تعالى عنهما, he said أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال وهو على المنبري. The Prophet mentioned وهو على المنبري, the Prophet was on the pulpit. وذكر الصدقة والتعفف والمسألة. The Prophet mentioned chastity, or to be chaste, صح? Yeah? أي نعم. And to also be a person who is self-sufficient and not. The Prophet, while he was talking about that, he said, الْيَدُ الْعُلْيَا خَيْرٌ مِّنَ الْيَدِ السُّفْلَى. The upper hand is better than the lower hand. Alamatu ibn al-Qayyim, he mentioned a benefit that I want to share with you all. Ibn al-Qayyim, he said, الْمَسْأَلَةُ فِي الْأَصْلِ حَرَامٌ. Asking for the from the people, يعني, the asal is that it's not allowed. وَإِنَّمَا أُبِيحَ لِلْحَاجَةِ وَالضَّرُورَةِ. But there's a need. So it doesn't have to reach ضَرُورَة. It doesn't have to reach what? ضَرُورَة. If there's a حاجة for it, there's a need for it, you're allowed to ask. It's permissible now. But other than that, the asal is that it's what? حرام. لِأَنَّهَا ظُلْمٌ فِي حَقِّ الرُّبُوبِيَةِ وَظُلْمٌ فِي حَقِّ الْمَسْؤُولِ وَظُلْمٌ فِي حَقِّ السَّائِلِ. Because it's oppression. It's an oppression when it comes to what? فِي الرُّبُوبِيَةِ, when it comes to Allah تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى's رُبُوبِيَةِ, meaning who is الرَّزَّاقُ, who does the action of rizq and providing? Allah. So you're coming with ظُلْم فِي حَقِّ الرُّبُوبِيَةِ وَظُلْمٌ فِي حَقِّ الْمَسْؤُولِ. Also the person who you're asking, you're oppressing them by taking their rights from them. When there's no need and you don't want it. You don't need it, you just want to increase your wealth. وَظُلْمٌ فِي حَقِّ السَّائِلِ. And it's also oppression on the one who's asking for it. And then Ibn al-Qayyim goes through how each of those three, it's an oppression. He goes through it. So, إِخْوَانِ فِي اللَّهِ, my beloved brothers and sisters, the first benefit that we took from this hadith today, وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ وَالْمِنَّةِ, is that what? The permissibility of what? Of asking if there is a what? A haja or darura. If there's a what? If there's a haja or a darura, you're allowed to ask. But if there isn't, who do you go back to? Who is the one who can give? Who is the one who provides? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ وَإِن يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَادَّ لِفَضْلِهِ يُصِيبُ بِهِ مَن يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Also Allah says, مَا يَفْتَحِ اللَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ رَحْمَةٍ فَلَا مُمْسِكَ لَهَا وَمَا يُمْسِكْ فَلَا مُرْسِلَ لَهُ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Allah is the one who accepts the dua of the one who calls onto him and begs him. Isn't Allah not the one who said, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Tawus ibn Kaysan, he said to Ata, إِيَّاكَ أَن تَطْلُبَ حَوَائِجَكَ إِلَى مَنْ أَغْلَقَ بَابَهُ دُونَكَ. Stay away from asking someone your needs who has locked the doors from you. وَيَجْعَلَ دُونَهَا حِجَابَهُ. And he has placed in front of you and him a veil. وَعَلَيْكَ بِمَنْ بَابُهُ مَفْتُوحٌ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Ask the one whose doors is always open. The one whose door is forever open. It never closes until the Day of Judgment. أَمَرَكَ أَنْ تَسْأَلَهُ وَوَعَدَكَ أَنْ يُجِيبَكَ. Allah has commanded you to ask Him, and He has made a promise to you that He will give you what you ask for. Al-Allamah, Al-Imam, Ibn Hajar, Rahimahullah, the hadith that we just took, the hadith, he transmitted from his Kitab Fathul Bari, because I mentioned to you that beginning that the hadith is in Sahih al-Bukhari. So Hafiz ibn Hajar transmitted from the great Imam, Ibn Battalin, Rahimahullah, that he said about the hadith of Aisha, hadith, the one I mentioned, he said, فِيهِ جَوَازُ سُؤَالِ الْمُحْتَاجِ. Ibn Battal mentioned that this hadith shows the permissibility of asking the one who needs it. And that is what is مُقَرَّر فِي كُتُبِ الْأُصُولِ, right? Which is أَنَّ الضَّرُورَاتِ تُبِيحُ الْمَحْضُورَاتِ وَالتَّعْسِيرِ سَبَبٌ لِلْتَيْسِيرِ. This is something that is spoken about in the books of أُصُول. If you go to الْمُوَافَقَاتًا, إِعْلَامُ الْمُوَقِّعِينَ, your شَرْحُ قَوَاعِدِ الْفِقِيَّةِ, the ulama يعبرون عن هذه القاعدة بتعبيرات يخالف تعبيري أنا. That تعبير I gave, some of it goes against, maybe they say different ways. يعني التعسير سبب لتيسير, some of them say المشقة تجلب التيسير وهكذا. But the end of the point, the end of the day is that if there's need for something, the Sharia permits it for you. Generally speaking, if you don't need it, my brother and sister, لَا تَخْضَعَنَّ إِلَى مَخْلُوقٍ وَطْرُقْ بَابَ مَنْ خَزَائِنُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بِيَدِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Do not humiliate yourself for a human being if you don't need it. And knock on the door, on the one whose door never closes. The one who owns the universe and everything that is in it. Everything is in His hand, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has it all, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا كُلٌّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. There is nothing that walks on this earth except that their provision is upon Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ, دَابَّةٍ can be even an ant. There's nothing that walks on this earth. إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا, your rizq is upon who? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا. Everything is free, كُلٌّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. Everything is there for you. وَلِذَلِكَ the poet, he said, لَا تَخْضَعَنَّ لِمَخْلُوقٍ عَلَى طَمَعٍ فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ نَقْصٌ مِنْكَ فِي الدِّينِ وَاسْتَرْزِقِ اللَّهَ مِمَّا فِي خَزَائِنِي فَإِنَّ رِزْقَكَ بَيْنَ الْكَافِ وَالنُّونِ. And don't humiliate yourself for a human being or a creation when there's no need for it. Because فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ نَقْصٌ مِنْكَ فِي الدِّينِ, that harms your religion. وَاسْتَرْزِقِ اللَّهِ, ask Allah for provision. مِمَّا فِي خَزَائِنِ, ask Allah for what is in His treasures. فَإِنَّ رِزْقَكَ, because your provision is between what? بَيْنَ الْكَافِ وَالنُّونِ. It's between كُن فَيَكُون. That's what it's between, right? Allah will give it to you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Human beings, when you ask too much, they don't like it. But Allah tabarak wa ta'ala does. Every time you ask Him, He will give it to you. You have to rely on Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. لو أنكم توكلتم على الله حق توكله لرزقتم كما ترزق الطير تغدو خماصا وتروح بطانا. The hadith of Imam Tirmidhi narrated in his Jami' and Ibn Majah in his Sunnah, Shaykh Albani rahimahullah authenticated. If you rely on Allah tabarak wa ta'ala the way that the bird relies on Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, Allah will provide for you the way He provides for the bird. The bird leaves with an empty stomach and it comes back with a full stomach. Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali, he said, قال الإمام أبو حاتم الرازي وهذا الحديث أصل في التوكل وأنه من أعظم الأسباب وأنه من أعظم الأسباب التي يستجلب بها الرزق قال الله تعالى ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. انتهى كلامه. الله تبارك وتعالى, if you ask him he will give it to you. لا تسألن بني آدم حاجة, don't ask the children of Adam for anything. وسل الذي أبوابه لا تحجب, ask the one that his doors are never locked. الله يغضب إن تركت سؤاله, Allah becomes angry if you don't ask him. وبني آدم, the children of Adam, لكن حين يسأل يغضب, the children of Adam when you ask them they become angry. So everyone should know that. لا تسألن بني آدم حاجة وسل الذي أبوابه لا تحجب, الله يغضب إن تركت سؤاله وبني آدم حين يسأل يغضب. Don't ask your needs from a human being. Ask the one whose doors never locked. The rulers, they lock their doors. They have security guards around them. Allah, no. Allah يغضب إن تركت سؤاله. Allah becomes angry if you don't ask him. But the children of Adam become angry if you ask them too much. So who should you ask? The one who gave everybody. Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to stop there. بإذن الله الكريم. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.